And Great Britain's Prime Minister says he's going to step down.
Channel 10, the one to watch. At 9 weekday mornings, the fun and games begin with that master wheeler dealer, Monty Hall, on Let's Make a Deal. And at 9:30, the fun continues as the couplets keep coming on Rhyme and Reason with host Bob Eubanks. All here weekday mornings.
On Channel 10, the one to watch.
From the wilds of scenic British Columbia to the warm and placid waters of southern Florida, animals are almost always doing fascinating things. Catching them at it is the work of the National Audubon Society's top photographers. Each year, these men and women personally present their own wildlife films, sharing their experiences with delighted audiences from coast to coast.
For information on local showings, phone Fort Lauderdale 522-9931.
Newswatch is next on WPLG Channel 10, Miami.
Good evening, I'm Ron Hunter. The Illinois primary results are in, and they are the same as Florida, with President Ford and Jimmy Carter winning their party's primaries. The president easily outdistanced Ronald Reagan to win his fifth straight primary. Carter won his fourth in five tries and his second straight against George Wallace. Here is a direct report from Chicago and Harry Reasoner.
President Ford and Jimmy Carter scored their biggest political victories of the year in today's Illinois primary. ABC News projects that when all the votes are in, Mr. Ford will get 60% of the Republican vote, Reagan 40%. On the Democratic side, ABC News projects that Jimmy Carter will wind up with 47% of the vote, well ahead of George Wallace's 26%, Sergeant Shriver with 17%, Fred Harris with 9%. We have videotape reactions from both Carter and Wallace. First, Carter.
Well, I think Governor Wallace is still in the same position he has been in the past, although apparently much more vulnerable. I don't think Wallace has ever projected himself to actually be elected president. He wanted to get enough delegates to go to the convention, to deadlock it, to put his ideas into the Democratic Party platform, perhaps to throw it in the House of Representatives when he was an independent candidate. And I think he might still go into the convention with a substantial number of delegates.
I feel very good at running second. I have a very strong core support in the United States, and I'm going to field it, and those who stand with me, I think you know, are with me. I think you know the poll showed in Florida that two out of five that voted against me wanted to vote for me, but they worried about my health. Of course, that is an issue, but my health's all right. I've withstood the rigorous campaign. I could be the president, but I can understand that question.
One of the surprises of the night is Carter's strong showing in the race for delegates against a slate placed to Illinois Senator Adlai Stevenson and backed by Chicago Mayor Richard Daley's political machine. At the moment, Carter has twice as many delegates as Stevenson. This is Harry Reasoner at ABC News Election Headquarters in New York.
There was an election locally today, and as a result, the city of Surfside has a new mayor. Samuel Brenner headed a field of five to win the mayor's job. Charles Hatton and Eli Lurie were also elected to the council. But as to which one of them will be vice mayor, that goes to the second highest vote getter. That decision will wait until absentee votes are counted. Incumbent Cy Howard lost his council seat. And Surfside voters approved a charter amendment which makes the council terms 2 years. Senator Lawton Childs has his first challenger for his Senate seat in this year's election. He is Dr. John Grady, who will run on the American Independent Party ticket. Grady ran for the Senate in 1974 and surprised everyone by getting 300,000 votes. And while we're going through the process of electing a president, Great Britain will be choosing a new leader. Prime Minister Harold Wilson says he will resign.
The first question everyone asked was why? Mr. Wilson himself explained it very simply, that he had been prime minister long enough, 8 years, more than anyone else in peacetime. Later in the day, he met with the press and explained that his decision was final and that it had nothing to do with recent troubles he's had with members of his own Labor Party, especially with the left wing. The Labor Prime Minister came into national prominence 13 years ago when he took over the leadership of the party. Since then, he has held the Prime Minister's post 4 times. He is highly regarded by his European colleagues for his intelligence and for his efforts at Atlantic unity. Even his political opponents at home are forced to admit that Mr. Wilson was a capable statesman and leader of his party and country.
The Labour Party has until Monday to pick a new leader. No new elections have been called, but it's expected that Conservatives will challenge the new Prime Minister soon. Another bomb has gone off in a London subway, but this one exploded after passengers had left the train. One man was injured by flying glass. This is the third subway bomb in 3 weeks. All are believed to have been set by Irish terrorists. There are unconfirmed reports tonight that the Naval Air Station at Key West will be closed. The Defense Department says it's closing a number of bases in an economy move and admitted some are in Florida. Spokesman at the air station said they had no comment on the report. 16 dogs and cats in southwest Miami have died from poison so far this year, and frightened residents want police help. They've even started a crime alert.
As far as I know, there have been 15 dogs poisoned. Two of mine have died, an Irish Setter and a Beagle Terrier, and the third one that I have was poisoned last Tuesday, but the police came and saved her. They brought her down to the vets in time enough that the veterinarian could take care of her.
What kind of poison was used, and any idea who might be doing it?
We don't know who's doing it, but a couple of people have been taking lab reports, and it's strychnine poisoning, heavy dosage.
Happy is the only survivor of 16 cats and dogs poisoned since January by strychnine and cyanide. The poisonings have been confined to 6 blocks of southwest Miami, but police are afraid that children may accidentally handle the poisons. Strychnine and cyanide can kill within hours if they are consumed. Police say the poisons seem to have been placed in food like meats and hamburgers and left on streets. That's an easy temptation for pets and children as well. Police suspect a disgruntled neighbor in the area is responsible, and they ask that if you know about the poisonings, to call them at 526-6185. Children in the area, police say, should be told of the dangers of poisons. I'm Chuck Gomez, Newswatch 10.
A Broward judge has decided that a scoutmaster was wrongly convicted and sentenced to prison 2 years ago, and he has set the man free. Jim Malone has details from Fort Lauderdale. Jim?
2 years ago, James Bush was a man without a police record, a school bus driver, an active church member, and a popular scoutmaster. Then a 7-year-old boy accused him of indecent assault. For 2 years, while Bush was shuttled in and out of prisons and road camps, the members of black and white church congregations where he was known rallied to his support. Yesterday, Bush got a chance to take a lie detector test, and he passed. With that added to his court file, he was finally set free.
Well, I feel that one has been educational to me, and for the words that it helped me and my family draw a lot closer, you know, and for the words that something that I can work a lot harder to keep a lot of the other young people from going to prison and jail if I can. And I just thank God that it's all over and came to an end.
Do you feel angry at those who were witnesses against you?
No, not exactly, you know, for the words, because in order to get forgiveness, I got to, for the words, be able to forgive them as well.
The Broward Public Defender's Office, which handled Bush's appeals, blamed the injustice on the private lawyer that he hired for his trial.
I think that most of the law enforcement officials involved in this case, the representatives from the state attorney's office, and particularly the trial judge, as the neutral arbiter of the case, acted fairly. It's just that they were not put on notice of the fact, and they couldn't have been under these circumstances, of the fact that the private trial attorney was not doing his job. And it was because of that fact that it took so long to bring the injustice to light.
Bush says his next step may be up to the girl he had planned to marry 2 years ago, if she's still agreeable. Ron?
Thank you, Jim. Good news on the national economic front tonight. Three leading indicators, housing starts, business inventories, and industrial production, all indicate the country is recovering from the worst recession since World War II. If you're one of the millions of Americans who can't wake up in the morning without a cup of coffee, bad news, coffee prices are going up again.
Coffee is grown in 42 different countries, but more than a third of it comes from Brazil. And last July, frost killed or severely damaged half of Brazil's 3 billion coffee trees. Since then, world coffee output has been reduced even more by the civil war in Angola, heavy rains in Colombia, and the earthquake in Guatemala. As a result, the average price of a pound of coffee on grocery shelves has soared from about $1.25 to $1.70 or more. Americans drank 140 trillion cups of coffee last year, so coffee prices are important. So important, in fact, that a House subcommittee today called two coffee executives on the carpet to ask what's going on. The executives said there's nothing they can do.
The coffee makers predict another 30 cent a pound increase in coffee prices before the end of the year. Coming up next on Newswatch, the defense is making its final attempt to show Patty Hearst did not willingly rob a bank, and the fighting continues in Beirut while the Lebanese president and rebels wait for each other to make a move.
Jefferson zips up Missy's fashion with cool cotton shifts and sleeveless two-pocket styles in bright spring prints. Sale price just $3.99 during Jefferson's four-leaf clover sale.
If you think that you're looking at a European luxury automobile, you're wrong. You're looking at the Chevrolet Custom Cloud. Distinctively different, uniquely luxurious, and exclusively customized for Potemkin Chevrolet. This automobile has to be seen to be appreciated, and it's reasonably priced so that you can afford it. See the Custom Cloud, only at Potemkin Chevrolet. It costs less than you think. Potemkin Chevrolet, America's largest Chevrolet dealer.
Even the most beautiful skin is sensitive to wind and sun, made to look dry and old before its time. Almay Deep Mist helps put back the moisture your skin thirsts for, softens dry skin, smooths harsh lines, and forms a protective barrier to minimize moisture loss. Hypoallergenic, unscented, Almay Deep Mist Moisture Cream or Lotion turns dry skin into fresher, younger-looking skin. The most beautiful skin under the sun.
You know what Breakstone sour cream does for a baked potato? And what it does for a chip dip? Well, now it's going to do something wonderful for your salad. Breakstone's new sour cream salad dressings. They're made with real Breakstone sour cream. So they're super creamy and delicious. You'll find the French, the Italian, all six flavors in the refrigerated produce section.
Patty Hearst's one-time best friend took the witness stand today in a continuing defense effort to show Miss Hearst was not a willing participant in bank robbery.
Tobin, who has known Patricia Hearst for 12 of her 22 years, then took the stand to testify on behalf of her friend. Bailey's partner, Al Johnson, asked Miss Tobin to comment on yesterday's statement by psychiatrist Harry Kozel that Miss Hearst was a rebel looking for a cause. Totally false, said Miss Tobin, whose father, incidentally, is president of the Hibernia Bank. Miss Hearst is charged with robbing a branch of that bank. And the witness described the defendant as having had a very warm family relationship. And Miss Tobin said a tape recording made of her conversation with Miss Hearst at the jail last September had been edited. The government has offered the tape in evidence, contending it contains revolutionary statements by the defendant. Still to be called by the defense, one and perhaps both of Patricia Hearst's parents. Stephen Geer, ABC News, San Francisco.
Randolph Hearst did take the stand late today, and he told the jury his daughter was bright and strong-willed, and he added he had seen no signs of discontent in Patty. Manson cultists Sandra Good and Susan Murphy were found guilty tonight of conspiring to mail death threat letters to business executives. The letters had accused the businessmen of polluting the environment. One of Broward's more infamous car drivers is back in trouble again. Once again, here's Jim in Fort Lauderdale. Jim.
Millionaire playboy Leo Goodwin III, the only person ever to be banned from the state's highways, was caught driving again. This time, police say he was drunk. Oakland Park police stopped a man they identified as Goodwin early this morning driving a Cadillac at a high rate of speed. Goodwin's license was lifted long ago. He could be held in contempt of court for violating a judge's order not to get behind a steering wheel. Goodwin has already spent some time in jail after a fatal accident. He's free now on probation. The Broward County Commission late this evening issued a call to the regional chief of the State Department of Transportation to help Broward's cause in a growing rift with Dade County over mass transit. The commissioners, led by Jack Moss, say Dade's federally backed mass transit plan ignores important regional problems in transportation. Two suspected drug dealers led police on a harrowing high-speed chase this evening that ended when the suspects crashed into a fire hydrant and a geyser of water engulfed their car and the two suspects inside. One was injured in the crash and the other had already been shot in the ankle during the 15-mile chase. A spokesman says officers were following the suspects as part of a lengthy drug investigation that will involve still more suspects. That was a day in Broward. Now back to Ron in Miami.
Thank you, Jim. Organized crime is big business in Florida. The State Crime Council says nearly 500 members of the organization or their associates are operating in the state. The council added most of the activity was centered here in South Florida, but it is now moving to the central part of the state. The standoff in Beirut continues tonight. Rebel forces want President Frangi to resign. The president says no. The once posh hotel district is again the scene of fighting. Dozens of people have been killed, wounded, or kidnapped. Rebel troops are near the presidential palace, and so far the only intervention of Syrian troops has prevented an all-out assault on the president's stronghold. Coming up next on Newswatch, Metro passes on cutting taxi rates, and Chuck has details on the continuing baseball strike.
Once in a while, an old car like this still pulls into an Exxon station. And when it does, it brings back memories. For instance, when this old friend came by back in the 30s, it was probably to try the new gasoline Exxon was introducing at that time. Down through the years, Exxon kept coming up with other new ideas as a result of their advanced product quality research. Today, Exxon retailers are still there to serve you, to help you make every mile count.
Here are some valuable pointers on America's number one Get Well card, Blue Cross and Blue Shield. One. On most group contracts, it pays in full for most in-hospital services and provides a room allowance selected by you. Two, it's nationally accepted by most hospitals and doctors. Three, it saves customers millions of dollars yearly through unique cost control methods. Now, America's number one Get Well card doesn't come cheap, but it's really worth it when you really need it.
There's a new man in my life, an exciting, marvelous Frenchman, Pierre Cardin. With his superb Cardin taste, he's created a perfume so rare and provocative that to wear it is deliciously luxurious. See for yourself. You can, now, at Burdine's. You'll receive a Persize perfume spray in an elegant drawstring pouch for only $3.50 with any Cardin de Pierre Cardin purchase. Thank you, Burdine's, for introducing me to this extraordinary Frenchman.
It's big. This special, this week only, from King. 200 new Oldsmobiles in stock. King, US 1 and Sunrise, Lauderdale.
Metro today took action which affects taxi riders, boat owners, and dog owners. Metro decided to wait until October before making any decision on cutting taxi fares. The county manager's office had proposed a reduction of 20 cents. The commission accepted a recommendation to freeze any increases in dock fees at county marinas for 60 days. Boat owners docking at the marinas argued that the hikes were unjustified. And also today, Metro accepted a report calling for rabies shots for dogs every 2 years. Currently, dogs are required to get rabies vaccinations yearly. Okay, now.
You just got a dog. We talked about that at 6 o'clock.
Absolutely. A big Doberman.
So you got to come up now.
What about the baseball situation, Slugger? Are they going to get back out there or not?
Not right away. That's the way it stands right now. But Major League Baseball players have rejected a proposal made by the owners yesterday, one that the owners had called at that time their final offer. And as it now stands, spring training is no longer the question. But now the question is, will the season open on time? Prospects look dim based on current statements from the warring factions. The rejection was made today by the players based on inadequacy. Now, let me tell you, essentially, they're upset that the owners tried to bluff them with this one-in-one offer, apparently allowing them to move as free agents after playing out their options. But in fact, they would only be allowed to move to the bottom eight teams, not anywhere that they wish, but only to the bottom eight teams. So talks will continue and camps will stay closed. The city of Miami missed today on its bid to land the 1978 Super Bowl. Instead, the NFL has sent Super Bowl XII to New Orleans, the new Superdome. And still, the owners' meeting in California, it continues. One of the things being discussed is the expansion draft, which is now to take place in a few weeks. And I talked with a man who will benefit from that draft, Tampa head coach John McKay.
Yeah, we're keeping busy. We're putting our playbook together. It's going to be one of the great books of our time. Right now, it's longer than Gone with the Wind. But we're coming along, and I think the draft will start about the end of this month, and we'll be all right.
You have filled out your coaching staff now. Did you get who you wanted, and are you pretty confident with the way things are shaping up for you?
Well, I did, because I started out with trying to get some younger college coaches to come with me, and I wanted some people who had a pro experience who I knew real well. And with Abe Gibber and Johnny Rauch, Dick Boris and Jerry Fry, we've got about 100 years of pro coaching experience, so we have some youthful people and other people who've been in the National Football League for many, many years.
You came right out of the college ranks and stepped into the pros, and first thing you know, we got a Cordtz suit and draft sailed up. Did you ever think, Lord, what have I gotten into?
I thought I left the NCAA, and I said, my Lord has followed me.
And it's following Denny Stoltz today. Denny Stoltz, the head football coach at Michigan State, he resigned this afternoon. That school recently put on NCAA probation for recruiting violations. Stoltz's resignation followed an announcement by the school that head basketball coach Gus Kanakis was being removed from his head coaching post. And we got scores for you tonight in the National Basketball Association. It was Los Angeles over Cleveland by 4 points tonight. Chicago down Phoenix 120-107. And Houston down New York by 5 points tonight. Two other games in the NBA are late starts. Over in the National Hockey League, off the ice tonight, Washington down the Rangers. There's a switch. Washington doesn't win many. Montreal over Pittsburgh by a goal tonight. Philadelphia stopped Atlanta 4-2. It was Minnesota over the Islanders by 2 goals. Chicago outskating Kansas City 5-1 after 2 periods. And there are 3 other games in the National Hockey League. They are all late starts. 2 former University of Miami coaches received big honors today. The late Jack Harding and Andy Gustafson, both former Hurricane head football coaches, were named as first recipients of the Distinguished Americans Award presented by the Football Hall of Fame Foundation. It was also announced that the two would be on this year's ballot for entry into football's Hall of Fame. And at the Biltmore Golf Course today, first round of the University of Miami Invitational Golf Tournament. And after today's play, FIU leads by 5 shots over Florida Atlantic. The U of M is 3rd, 7 shots back of the leaders. Second round action tomorrow at the Biltmore Course. In baseball tonight, the Hurricanes beat Southern Illinois 9-6 using a school record 7 double plays. Miami is now 12-6 on the year. Boxing on the beach tonight, 2 good fighters in the main event at the Miami Beach Convention Center. Undefeated lightweight Termite Watkins in the dark purple trunks, 23-0 against Nani Marrero in the dark red. Marrero, a winner over Jose Peterson. He made it another upset tonight by winning a split decision over Watkins. One of the judges scored it a draw, and I was there, folks, and there wasn't any way this one was a draw. Let me tell you, Marrero controlled this one from the outset and cut Watkins badly in the ninth round. And for Marrero, the win is his 20th. His record now 27-3. Watkins is 23-1. Quite a fight over there. And that's sports. Here's Ron.
All right, Chuck. Defense Secretary Donald Rumsfeld has sharply reprimanded the Pentagon's research chief. Rumsfeld ordered Dr. Malcolm Curry to forfeit 4 weeks' pay for accepting an invitation to a hunting lodge owned by Rockwell International. That is a major defense contractor. Now, from Hunter and hunting to Walt and the weather and wet and windy.
Right, we better go right now or we're going to get wet before we get home.
We'll be back in just a minute.
If you had something that could do this, you could do this. With little effort and in no time at all, Weed Eater gets to those hard-to-get-to places. And Weed Eater does it safely because it cuts with fishing line. Weed Eater. At last, someone's found a way.
When the Orange Bowl became the Super Bowl, this stadium was filled with over 80,000 people. But every day, more people bank with Barnett. In fact, more people do business with us in more places than any other bank in Florida. And here's why. We treat every customer as if they were the only one we ever had. Barnett Bank. When you do business with us, you don't get lost in the crowd.
Come to Israel and see thousands of years come to life. This year, come and say shalom.
RC Cola, now an easy carry 4-pack cartons of 32-ounce bottles. Special price at most stores. Limited time.
Me and my weatherman here now. Walter?
I'm tired of all that dancing I just did.
They don't know what you're talking about.
But there's a cold front dancing down the coast tonight. It's going to whip through here in a little while, so look out for some showers and thunderstorms at about 1:15 in the Miami-Fort Lauderdale area. A cold front tonight from a low center over New Jersey, southward through the Carolinas, down through the Florida Panhandle. It will move off the southeast coast by about daybreak in the morning, and it's going to move all the way out into the central Bahamas by tomorrow night. A lot of showers and thunderstorms associated with it. There's a lot of snow and rain associated with that low pressure system over New Jersey. Heavy snow warnings are out tonight for portions of the middle Atlantic states, central New York, and in parts of New England, with 8 to 14 inches expected up that way by tomorrow morning. 7 inches of snow fell in some parts of New York earlier today. And now let's take a look at some of the highs and the weather around the nation this afternoon. Up in the northeast, Baltimore was 49 and cloudy. Buffalo, 27 and snow today. Washington, 52 and rain. In the southeast, Memphis, 54 and rain earlier today. Out in the Midwest, Chicago, 32 and cloudy. Cleveland had a little snow with 34. In the far west, El Paso, 67 and sunny. Reno, 71 and sunny. The hot spots today, Miami and Vero Beach with 87 degrees. North Miami Beach also. And in International Falls, Minnesota, it was 13 below zero. Outside Channel 10 right now, the temperature is 74 degrees, a relative humidity 82%. The winds are out of the southwest at 8 miles an hour. The barometer at sea level 29.99 and falling. The surf is 77 degrees. That front, about 2 o'clock in the morning, will lie along the line from Vero Beach all the way down to Everglades City. It'll pass through the Miami area about 6:30 tomorrow morning. Now, showers and thunderstorms are sweeping across South Florida at the present time, and they'll be passing off the southeast coast about 2:30 or 3 o'clock in the morning. We're going to hear some thunder and see some lightning during the night. The winds will be out of the southwest ahead of the front, and they're going to shift around the northwest at about 20 to 25 miles an hour after the front goes through. Small craft advisories are out everywhere. Keep your boat on the trailer. The next high tide of government cut will occur at 8:50 in the morning, and we'll have a low tide at 2:43 in the morning. My forecast for Miami, showers and thunderstorms tonight, and a little cooler tomorrow. The low in the morning, 62, but 67 on the beach. The high tomorrow afternoon, 78. And the fearless forecast, Thursday through Saturday, mostly sunny and mild. The lows in the 60s, the high up around 80. And Ron, we better get out of here.
All right, Walter, these pictures in the news tonight. Princess Margaret of England and her husband, Lord Snowden, reportedly about to separate. They've been married 16 years. Actor Richard Burton, separated from his wife Liz Taylor, is now courting this lady, Susan Hunt. And Mary Pickford, the sweetheart of the silent screen and now almost a recluse, allowed her picture to be taken today with husband Buddy Rogers. For her films like this one in 1929, she'll receive a special Oscar at the Academy Awards here on Channel 10 in 2 weeks. That's all we have right now. Join Ann Bishop at 5:30, Chuck Walden and me again at 6 tomorrow. For the entire Newswatch team, I'm Ron Hunter. Have a good evening.
Stay tuned now as Political Spirit of 76 looks at the Illinois primary, coming up on Channel 10.
Jefferson,
you know, it's easy to talk about saving gasoline. Well, the people on Claremont Street are saving it, cutting down, driving sensibly, choosing their gasoline sensibly. Like Citgo NOLED for newer cars to help save money on tune-ups, or Citgo Regular for most other cars. Two good values. And 8 out of 10 cars today can use one or the other. When you have to drive, do it sensibly. And remember Citgo. We help keep you going.
Jefferson's four-leaf clover sale starts Wednesday from the paint department. Montgomery Ward GOC 25 one-coat interior flat latex in 25 decorator colors. And Montgomery Ward acrylic latex 15 flat exterior paint in a choice of 15 colors that dry fast to a blister-resistant finish. Both sale priced, your choice, just $5.99 a gallon. That's right, the interior flat latex or the exterior acrylic flat latex, your choice, just $5.99 a gallon during Jefferson's four-leaf clover sale starting Wednesday.
Introducing an automobile that's just a little better. A Bill Binko used car. For 17 years, Bill Binko has been uncompromising quality in used cars, with each one completely reconditioned and carrying a written guarantee. Shop and compare. We know you'll buy Binko, and you'll save money. Remember, at Bill Binko, you drive out with a part of our name.
The following is a WPLG Channel 10 editorial. Speaking for the editorial board is Norman Davis, Vice President for News and Public Affairs.
State action and a tough disciplinary campaign by the medical associations and the Florida Bar are needed, we believe, to halt Florida's automobile insurance crisis. Those recommendations were contained in yesterday's WPLG editorial. Today, our attention is focused on the awards dilemma, or the tendency of Florida juries to vote massive settlements to accident victims, and the willingness of some insurance companies to acquiesce to multi-million dollar out-of-court settlements. Each time a jury votes exorbitant punitive damages, and each time an insurance company exceeds without a fight, it costs the consumer money. Ultimately, all those awards are passed on to the policyholder, increasing his insurance costs as well as his frustration, and thereby continuing the vicious circle. It's a rule of thumb among insurance men that when a dazed jury hears a padded injury claim resulting in a week off from work and a $1,200 hospital bill, a $6,000 verdict is almost assured. Little wonder there's an avalanche of such claims on the court calendar, and little wonder insurance costs keep rising. As long as the public continues to punish itself by attempting to punish the auto insurance companies, and as long as insurance companies get away with passing along unchallenged costs, the spiral will continue to spin.
WPLG encourages the presentation of contrasting points of view by responsible spokesmen. Watch The Vanishing Shadow tomorrow at 7 on 10.
Tuesday Mystery of the Week, The House and the Brain, will be seen in its entirety 50 minutes from now, following this ABC News report.
Tonight in Illinois, President Ford's fifth straight victory, also a triumph for Democrat Carter.
So I think a good showing in Illinois not only helps me there with future delegate decisions, but also helps me in succeeding states down the line in the rest of the country.
Carter's far ahead of Wallace in second place.
I feel very good at running second. I have a very strong core support in the United States, and I'm going to field it, and those who stand with me, I think you know, are with me.
But many Illinois delegates are moving toward Carter, who is a big winner tonight. Political spirit of 76. ABC News coverage of the Illinois primary. Reporting from New York, ABC News correspondent Harry Reisner. Good evening. Jimmy Carter's victory in Illinois today was more substantial than had been anticipated. ABC News projects that when all of the returns are in, he will have about 47% of the vote, not far from a majority. The vote count is slow in Illinois, especially in rural areas, but right now, with about 29% of the precincts in, Jimmy Carter is ahead with 191,000 votes, 47.5% of the total. George Wallace is second with 106,000, 26.5%. Sergeant Shriver, who had some hopes in Illinois, a long third with about 18%. Fred Harris with 18%.